lush and tropical, and also volcanic as hell. I don't just mean that, like, speaking metaphorically. Like,
anomaly on sensors.
It's pretty volcanic.
Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Nice, please have some ESO, please have some ESO, please have some ESO, please have some ESO. Ah, brilliant. That's nice, too. Let's explore the system. For first approaches, we'll actually see the planetary approach, so I can see the planet for the first time. Research station here, but it's not in the best shape. Appears to be basically very mercurial. In the sense of, like, the planet Mercury. So, this is next, let's hit up here. There. And then back across to over here. Binary star system. And we have not binary star system, but a gas giant with a moon. And
anomaly on sensors. Satellite detected.
Aha. And that will take care of the satellite. I suspect they'll appreciate knowing that the cat satellite was here and that we've taken it out for them. Or at the very least, let it decide whether to take it out or not, because they may want to keep it up and running for purposes of surveillance. Gas giant that is bleeding atmosphere due to proximity to the scourge. And finally, this world. Oh, Bayaro, I believe is how it's pronounced. I do like these approach angles. Big bunch of scourge over there. That'd be nice if we got some way to force it to retract.
Anomaly on sensors.
Hey.
A huge mineral deposit.
Graphite. System fully scanned. Well, there's a Nexus. Varro and Gerator. So we have two different wings we can go to. We have Nalatesh, Joba. So we have a bunch more quests over in Voeld. So let's hit up that side first. With them being a side quest for Peeb. Oh, right.
I'm picking up something. Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Let's sweep the system before we head into Chorl for our final approach. We have to bail out in a hurry. I'd like to make sure we have good charts for the system. I see some scans actually may get us some information that'll help us later. We'll see.
Anomaly detected. Probe away. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Ah, an Angaran escape pod. Okay. Except there's a Quarian nav processor and a bunch of other similar tech there. Huh. It looks like the loot is determined procedurally, and so occasionally we had some glitches like that. Where a Angaran ship has tech that it should not have.
Anomaly detected.
Oceans of nitrogen. Fascinating. I know this is very Spock of me. There we go. Nitrogen adapted. Neat. Now, let's go to Voeld. Our next big series of quests.
Bundle up, people.
I'll stay on my nice warm ship.
That's fair. Find our landing site. Take us down. All right, we're gonna need Joel on this one. And we'll take Drak as my second party member on this. How well you two hit it off. Hopefully not in the physical contact sense. Oop. Well, let's do this.
Take her down, Callow.
Interesting.
Original readings suggest that it had a breathable, nitrogen-rich atmosphere and oceans of H2O.
I take it that's no longer the case.
All H2O on Habitat 6, Voeld to the Angari, is ice. And those oceans, frozen over completely.
There goes the dream of a seaside property.
Well, if we activate a vault, activate the vault, we may be able to recover it.
That's a pretty intense blizzard.
LZ is on the windward side of the mountain. Conditions are bad. I'm tracking Gale
Force. Hey, not chronic radiation. That's good. Steady. We are down. So, we're gonna be here for a bit.
We're good. We're good.
You sure? Want us to get out and push?
Very funny, Ryder.
Oh, right. I need PB here. I need PB for the other party member, because one of the questions is for her. Shoot. Alright, so...
Suvi wasn't kidding about the cold.
All right. This looks like a nearby closer location.
Temperatures are below freezing and continuing to fall.
Ahead of the resistance base. Hopefully that'll serve, that we can get a fast travel point there and it'll give us a good forward location for further exploration.
Secluded. Blizzard provides cover. Great for a hidden base.
Keep going, Ryder. Try not to make any sudden movements. You're probably being watched.
How many snipers do you think I got trained on me?
The very least, get some iridium out of this. This is gonna go hypothermic.
Heater straight on. Any squishies need to warm up.
We're almost there. We'll need to talk to Commander Anyik when we arrive.
There we go. Resistance base. Aha, little heaters, space heaters sitting around.
Temperatures are below freezing and continuing to fall.
Took 2 hours to scrape me out of my ship.
I'm reading a normal temperature range.
Interesting.
Life support is back online.
Takeoff isn't for a while.
There's a going space heater, space heater. Safe condition, just only negative 30 below freezing. Celsius. Yeah, negative 30 Celsius.
Fuel pumps, fuel lines, hydraulics, all looking good.
Yeah, I told you. I take good care of her. Can it go now?
Gotta check the engine.
That'll take forever.
Extreme cold is detected, Pathfinder.
There we go, just the cruiser. Whew. Barely made it, huh?
Environmental temperatures are within acceptable limits.
Yeah, this just rips through your...
But I love you, Hera.
I know.
Pardon me.
Who knows how much time we have?
Base. Two consoles to provide quest items.
Environmental temperatures are within acceptable limits.
I hear you have a very impressive vehicle.
Yes, I do. Sorry for tapping that.
I'm an amateur mechanic myself. Build vehicles for my people.
Upload this schematic for your mechanic, with my compliments. They can upgrade your vehicle shielding once you find the need.
Yes, that is exactly what I need.
He lives for this shit. It will make his day.
My long-lost brother. You can find some of what you need here on Voeld. The rest, out and about.
Life support restored.
Shield regenerator, that's what... Don't mind me.
Michelle's explosion. She would have known exactly how to do it.
There's a couple consoles over here. Let's check them out. Maybe some quest stuff we can pick up. Pardon my throat clearing.
We didn't hear about the human. Landed right in the middle of my...
We're gonna need some kind of stimulant.
Well, I have Kajarian Superhead.
Yes, what is it? You're that alien they've been talking about on comms, aren't you? Why are you standing here? Shouldn't you be talking to the commander?
I'm Pathfinder Ryder with the Andromeda Initiative from...
Wonderful. You're from far away. Do they have magical healing?
Weird graphical glitch there.
Nothing more advanced than what you have.
Then where you're from is useless to me right now. Stand over there.
The commander said the alien wanted to help. But we need it. The emergency caches, maybe.
Emergency caches?
This is a war zone. Ked attacks are always a risk. Wounded. There's probably a cache of emergency medical supplies nearby. No substitute for real medical attention, but you'll survive long enough to reach it.
Problem is the caches are empty right now. Restrained and no one's been out there to replenish supplies.
I can do it.
There's no time to waste. I'll help with whatever you need.
Supply crates are stacked by the wall over there. Directions to the caches are with them. You have a vehicle?
Of course.
Good. Get going.
All right. Bummer.
Looks like supplies aren't getting through to the Resistance.
Olisk is in charge of requisitions. We should speak with him.
These are the emergency medical supplies the doctor mentioned. We have to get them to the caches. Sam, you saving the location data?
Of course, right. Pathfinder.
If you need patching up, you'll have to wait. A patrol just came through. All right. I need to see to them.
You guys seem very understaffed.
Volunteer medics are hard to come by, especially ones who can handle Voeld.
Need heaters brought in?
It's actually warm in here. Those heaters work pretty well.
We don't use them for heat. They generate artificial sun, so we don't go dark.
What do you mean, go dark?
Right, I suppose you wouldn't know about that. Our bodies generate energy.
Aha.
If we don't get enough, our immune systems weaken and our bioenergy slows. We go dark.
It can't be easy living in a place like this.
Between the cold and the lack of sun, it's tough to keep morale up. Most of us come from Aya or Haval, so it's a big adjustment. Immunity drops, people get sick. But if the civilians in the settlements can live here without complaint, so can we.
I'll come back if I need anything.
I'll be here.
Scan all these heaters. I can't scan one of these heaters, darn.
Jarl, have you come back to us?
Briefly.
And these must be the strangers I've heard so much about. You know, if not for Jarl, I might kill you.
This is my friend, Maisie. She helps supply the resistance.
That must be difficult out here.
Jarl's the brave one.
How do you get supplies with a Ket everywhere?
The same way we came. There are caves and hidden paths all over the world.
It's hard to fly in, so my children run most items through the caves, little by little.
Children?
Their size makes it hard for the Ket to detect. We all do what we can out here.
Got it.
Children.
Are you selling anything we could use?
I have almost nothing left. What I do have, we need if we're going to stand any chance against the Ket. Maybe if you clear that Ket station on the South Road, I'd be able to bring in more and spare something for you.
And new quest item on the list.
How do you feel about Ephra?
Some speak ill of the man, but his plan is bold and the resistance is important. I'll do what I can to help until I can't help.
That's
any.
Fair.
Good luck and stay safe.
Just make sure you return Jarl to us.
Alright, so got a couple new quests. Another terminal. They have some worries about what I did, and presumably what Papa Ryder did. Let's hit the command post.
Got a message from my little brother.
Good to see you again, Commander Dozio.
And you, Jarl. This is the alien. The one you think can help us.
Yes. This is Ryder, of the Andromeda Initiative.
I am Anyik Dozeel. Remember the name, because if you betray us, I will kill you.
Got it? Not my intent.
Be assured that what I do to you will make the stars turn their faces and grow dark.
I have no intention of betraying you.
Say what you want. It is the hands that reveal
That's fair.
Your intention. If you wish to prove yourself, be an ally in our fight against the Ket. Despite our best efforts, their growing forces remain a threat to our people. Speak to our lookouts, who watch the valley. They'll know where our need is dire. Jarl, watch them. And be careful yourself, my friend.
I always am.
All right. So it looks like they might be getting wise to their surveillance network.
Pathfinder, something I can do for you?
You the requisitions officer? I hear you're having supply issues.
Of course not. I don't know what you've heard, but everything is running fine.
Your communications say otherwise. You haven't received a shipment in weeks.
Those data pads are encrypted. How did you... I need to keep this news contained. No one knows the shipment has stopped. If word gets around, we'll have a serious morale drop. I need to investigate this quietly.
You have any leads?
Not much. The supplies make it planetside, but never reach the base. The obvious answer is the Ket. Sabotage is their style. We changed our drop point, but no luck. I can't send someone to investigate without word getting around. I guess there's no avoiding it eventually.
I'll check it out.
I can take a look at the drop point. That way, no one will panic.
I can't sanction an official search, but I also can't stop you from investigating on your own. The nav point for the last drop location is in my personal console. You seem to be adept at decryption, so I'll let you figure
out. Okie dokie.
Ciao, my friend. Welcome home, brother.
Alright.
Decryption successful, Pathfinder. Updating your nav system with a supply drop point.
Probably the other place I'll have a good idea of where I can trust deploy a drop pod.
It's good to be back. I have friends here.
Let's try to make a good first impression.
They know I'm not gonna eat them, right?
Lookouts are over here. Okay.
But I brought the snacks last time.
But I never get care packages from IAD.
How you doing?
Whoa, didn't mean to sneak up on you. Your commander said you could show us the valley.
Zeke, I don't want to talk to it. You talk to it.
Ryder has a name.
You named it? How do you even tell them apart?
Stars, Veniska, just talking.
Yeah, we can show you the valley. What are you looking for?
I'm here to help your people. Know anyone who needs it?
We've got reports from Hajara about someone trying to rescue a kidnapped family. See those red lights? That's it. If you're here to help, like the commander says, you could start there. Anything else?
Remnant tech.
Do you know of any remnant sites or ruins?
I think so. Actually, I don't know.
Zeke, do you ever read the dailies?
No, you'll tell me if I need to know something.
So, where is it?
Tall lights, over on your right somewhere.
Those red lights, you said that's Hajara?
Yes, Hajara Station, one of the Dar in the valley. It's a small community, okay. Mostly scientists. There's people there that might need help if you haven't checked it out already.
How does anyone live?
Very carefully.
Why so surprised? We've adapted to this weather.
Those lights are conspicuous. Don't the Ket attack?
We've adapted
to that.
That's
fair.
The Ket want to take us alive, so we fight to the death. It seems to deter them.
What's that alien facility on that mountain over there?
That's the Ket Command Center. We have constant eyes on it.
What's its purpose?
It controls Ket operations on the entire planet. There's all
right, blow that up.
I came face to face with the prefect there. Meanest, motherless Bissan I ever saw.
Even the Ket seemed afraid. We don't have much intel on her, though.
I'll let you get back to your work.
Yeah, you behave. We're right. Watching you.
So we have...
Tempest, we're going to need the Nomad. My position.
Deploying forward station. Good luck, Ryder.
Activating automated forward station deployment. I'm reading a severe temperature drop. Mining zones have been added to your nav system,
nice.
I'm reading a normal temperature range.
Well, the Nomad.
Life support restored.
Okay, Sam, what's Voeld got for us?
Ket activity appears to be centered around this large central command post. According to Resistance Intelligence, the base coordinates all Ket military efforts.
Blow that up and it gets disorganized.
And taking it down will cripple their operations.
In theory. However, given the trouble the Angara Resistance has had infiltrating the base, it will not be a simple task. I recommend a more cautious approach that starts with the investigation of smaller Ket installations.
Any suggestions on how to get on Ephra's good side?
Resistance dispatches indicate there is someone in Hajara who needs help. We could visit Tekix, a larger and more established Angara Dar that is nearby.
Sounds good. Thanks, Sam.
Pathfinder, Voeld's temperature range is fixed well below freezing, with pockets of even more severe conditions. This necessitates the use of the Nomad. I advise against prolonged exposure to the cold.
Got it. Don't crash the car.
Our scans have detected remnant monoliths, which suggests the presence of a Voeld.
That means we might be able to melt this ice cube. All right, we've got our work cut out for us. Let's get going.
So, activate the Voeld, and environmental conditions theoretically improve. Load that real quick. I want to keep Jol in the party, but I want to swap out Drac for now with PB. Alright, and then save my game. And that's a 2-hour stream, so I'm going to call it for today for now. I may stream a little bit later, but I've got other stuff going on today. So I will handle editing this in some bits and put it up on the YouTube channel for a more manageable viewing later. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe to the YouTube channel and to the Twitch channel or Blip channel or wherever it is you're watching this. And check out my Patreon at patreon.com/count0or. That's count ZEROOR. And when future... And back in the channel will help give you control over, say, what games I stream in the future. As well as helps me do this more often. Get your name in the credits of my shows. Get a copy of my fanzine. And like an actual physical copy of my fanzine in the mail and a whole bunch of other great stuff. So check that out. Till then, thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you next time.